So now the current affair topics such as farmer protests, you need to prepare in a two dimension. So today we'll have a discussion on current affairs topic, that is farmer protest. So now the current affair topic such as farmer protest, you need to prepare in a two dimension. One, you need to prepare with factual information, which is going to help you in your prelims. Second, you need to identify that these topics, how you have to write down some important points for your mains. Now, another important part is that farmer protest ke upar aapko question GS 1 topic pe bhi aa sakta hai, topic 2 pe bhi aa sakta hai, topic 3 pe bhi aa sakta hai. So, aapko identify karna padega demand of the question. For instance, agar GS 1 mein question aata hai, so ye question, it's a part of Indian society. It's a part of not many subtopics, for example, social issues and problems in India. Okay, so developmental problem, vulnerable sections ke jo issues hai. So how you need to articulate your answer. Okay, so today we're going to talk about that broadly. So first of all, what you will see is that we need to understand this Punjab, for instance, Punjab farmer protest in a broader manner. Okay, so for that, we do have to have clarity over our syllabus, and it is a part of Indian society. Or Indian society mein hum isko kahan pe rakhenge? We will put into the agrarian sector. Okay, so agrarian transformation in India can be a better heading for understanding farmer protest or GS1. Ab kuch important points aapko pata hona chahiye. So generally aspirants ye mistakes karte hai, that they started writing any issues in a very factual manner. So aapko facts nahi batane yahan pe, you do not have to report ke farmer protest ho raha hai, usme MSP ka issue hai, so minimum support price ye hai, ye is ministry ke under aata hai, ye challenges hai. Aapko identify karna hai ke major problem kya hai. Okay, so the major problem is basically, you can have lot many points. For instance, you can talk about agricultural practices. It is talking about rural social structure, land tenure systems, class structure in rural India, peasants' differentiation, mode of production, and very importantly, that whensoever we have economical changes, so jab bhi humko hamare paas kuch economical changes aate hai, wo it may give rise to conflicts. Okay, so ye kuch important dimensions hai jis pe aapko apne answers ko frame karna hota hai. So it's really very important to articulate your answer in a correct manner. Now, when identifying this important dimension, you need to give references, right? Aapko wo references dena aana chahiye. So all these issues have already been studied. Kisi agriculturalist ne study kara hoga, kisi political economics ne kara hoga, sociologist ne kara hoga. So kuch reports, kuch thinkers ke kaam ko aapko refer aap kar sakte ho. For instance, peasants and workers in the rural economy. Now in this book, A.L. Desai is explaining that how do we have peasants differentiation. So peasants may be kuch rich farmers hote hain, kuch middle class farmers hote hain, kuch poor farmers hote hain. Ab Punjab aur Haryana mein common belief mana jata hai that they are coming from the rich class, but it is not the case. Now here you need to talk about the facts that even in Punjab or Haryana belt, we do have a small marginal farmers jinka land holding kam hai, jinko government ki taraf se support ki bahut zarurat hai, subsidies ki bahut zarurat hai. Okay, so these are important points which you have to reflect your answer. Ab yahan pe aap jab small marginal farmers ke issues ko aap relate karoge, you can refer to some reports, you can refer to some fact ki according to this report, according to this data, वो आपके आंसर में आना चाहिए, क्योंकि आप कोई एक सोशियोलॉजिकल आंसर नहीं लिख रहे हैं, आपको GS1 का ही आंसर लिख रहे हैं, लेकिन यू नीड टू आइडेंटिफाई इम्पॉर्टेंट टॉपिक्स. फाइन, सो यू नीड टू से कि ऐसा नहीं है, पंजाब में भी आपको फार्मर्स को सपोर्ट की ज़रूरत है. अब जब आप ये सारा पॉइंट बता रहे हैं, यू कैन रेफर टू A.L. Desai, So A.R. Desai in his book Peasants and Workers in the Rural Economy has bring out some similar points. आप दानागिरी की काम को भी refer कर सकते हैं. And then you have M.S. Swaminathan. We all know that M.S. Swaminathan, he is considered as the father of green revolution. उनका क्या contribution है? जब आप Swaminathan को for instance explain कर रहे हैं, then you give reference. For instance, just write down his book name: Globalization, Agrarian Crisis, and Farmer Suicide. So जो पंजाब का issue है, इट इज रिफ्लेक्टिंग एग्रेरियन क्राइसिस इन इंडिया. ये कोई एक फार्मर प्रोटेस्ट कोई किसी एक फार्मर्स किसी एक ग्रुप का प्रॉब्लम नहीं है, ये लार्जर इंडियन इकोनॉमी में एग्रेरियन क्राइसिस का प्रॉब्लम है. डेफिनेटली इसके हिस्टोरिकल रूट्स भी रहे होंगे. अब आप हिस्टोरिकल रूट्स नहीं एक्सप्लेन कर सकते, यू कैन जस्ट से इट हैज़ अ हिस्टोरिकल रूट्स बिकॉज 150 वर्ड्स का आंसर है. तो वर्ड बजटिंग करना भी बहुत इंपॉर्टेंट है, राइट? सो ये कुछ पॉइंट आप लिख सकते हैं कैसे एक मॉडल आंसर कैसे. आई एम जस्ट ट्राइंग टू टेल कैसे आप एक मॉडल आंसर रिलेट करोगे, कैसे आप अपने इंट्रोडक्शन लिखोगे. सो आई हैव जस्ट गॉट दिस पॉइंट. फॉर इंस्टेंस यू कैन से दैट एग्रेरियन ट्रांसफॉर्मेशन इन इंडिया हैज बीन अ कॉम्प्लेक्स फिनोमिना, राइट? रीसेंट फार्मर प्रोटेस्ट इन पंजाब, वी ऑल नो दैट इन पंजाब एग्रीकल्चर इज अ सिग्निफिकेंट पार्ट ऑफ द इकोनॉमी. नाउ issues related to land ownership, land reforms or economical policies, it plays a crucial role in understanding agrarian crisis in India. Yahan pe aapne aisa introduction frame kiya, then you need to talk about the major points jo maine bhi aapse discuss kare. You can use some sort of flow charts here. For example, A.R. Desai ka work Peasants and Workers in the Rural Economy, he has talked about differentiation among peasants, he has talked about impact of economical changes, how we need to bring the solutions to their problems. So agricultural practices or technological adoption, jab bhi hamari country karti hai usme kuch bhi solutions leke aane ki koshish karti hai. For example, recently government wants ki India ka jo agriculture sector hai wo globally compete kare. So if you really want India's agriculture to of global level, you want us to compete, so isme aapko kya isme government ka kya role hona chahiye, kya aapko karna chahiye, solution kya hai iska. So ye sare kuch points inhone apni book pe discuss kare hai. So you know that whensoever we have economical changes, it may contribute to conflict in agrarian regions. Now the suggestion which is given to us by Swaminathan, unka book ka naam aapne likh liya, Globalization, Agriculture and Crisis of Farmer Society. So he is definitely looking it in a comprehensive manner ki agrarian crisis ko aapko holistic manner mein samajhna hai. So what is the land use patterns, what is water management there, how we can have input cost, indebtedness, crop failures, sustainable agriculture programs. Now when you are referring to the workers, to the like, you know, when you are referring to such kind of work, जैसे स्वामीनाथन का आपने रेफर किया या एल डिसाई का या दानागिरी का, आप अपने आंसर में कंक्रीटनेस लेके आते हो, राइट? सो यू हैव अ कंप्लीट इंफॉर्मेशन. नाउ यू कैन ऑल्सो रिकमेंड सजेशंस. सो नाउ यू कैन रेफर टू द रिपोर्ट्स. यू कैन से दैट बिफोर इम्प्लीमेंटिंग एनी इकोनॉमिकल चेंजेस इन पॉलिसीज, वी मस्ट हैव लॉट ऑफ फील्ड स्टडीज, वी शुड नो द स्टेटस, इकोनॉमिकल स्टेटस ऑफ पीजेंट्स, सब्सिडीज हमको कितनी देनी चाहिए, उनका इम्प्लीमेंटेशन कैसा होना चाहिए. सो यू हैव टू टॉक अबाउट ऑल दीज एस्पेक्ट्स इन योर आंसर. यू कैन नॉट सिंपली टेल व्हाट इज गोइंग ऑन, यू रेदर हैव टू टॉक अबाउट दीज सिग्निफिकेंट पॉइंट्स. इवन इफ यू आर गिविंग सोल्यूशन, यू कैन नॉट जस्ट से लाइक दैट, यू नीड टू ब्रिंग सम रिपोर्ट्स. ओके, आप रिपोर्ट्स को रेफर करके आप बता सकते हैं. सो फॉर इंस्टेंस, इफ वी आर हैविंग लॉट ऑफ फील्ड स्टडीज, तो अगर गवर्नमेंट कोई भी पॉलिसी में चेंजेस लेके आती है एंड स्पेसिफिकली इन एग्रीकल्चर सेक्टर, और उसमें फील्ड स्टडीज होती है, सो वी हैव बेटर डेटा, वी हैव बेटर डेटा टू असेस देयर प्रॉब्लम्स. तो उनको क्या क्या प्रॉब्लम हो सकती है, उनको हमको कैसे सपोर्ट करना है, तो ये सारे पॉइंट्स में आपको आंसर लिखना चाहिए, राइट? So this is really very important how you are writing your answer with having lot many perspectives. Okay, so farmer issues has a lot many points to discuss. It is just not about minimum support price. It is just not about that how they are protesting for basic rights. You need to talk about that how this issue has a long historical roots. A lot many sociologists, agriculturalists, Swaminathan or A.R. Desai and all these thinkers, kaise in logo ne isko relate kiya hai, right? And then how it is very, very important for us that India's villages should solve their internal complex problems. Because as M.N. Srinivas have said, that how India is representing India's villages is a microcosm of Indian society. So India ko jo representation hai, it is not in urban centers, it is rather in agriculture region. So agriculture development hona bahut zaruri hai, because we are a developing nation, we are having agricultural economy. Okay, so ye sare points aap apne answer mein likh sakte hain. Aapko identify karna padega ki kis way mein ye question pucha gaya hai. Okay, I hope you like my suggestion. Thank you.